All right, hello everybody. It is Jackson Blue from Country 102.5 with Jordan Davis. Hot damn. My first experience with country radio when I switched over, I did a lot of pop radio before, was an event we did with your brother, with Jacob Davis.
Oh yeah.
And moving from pop radio where none of the artists really talk to you all that much, and then Jacob was like following me around the room the whole time.
Yeah, he's a pretty talkative dude.
I was like, what is this country music thing? Yeah. Why are you guys so nice?
Why is that guy following me? You were probably more like, dude, why is that guy following me around like real creepily? Yeah. No, man, I think there is. There's a lot of good people in country music. So.
Absolutely. And you're one of them, no doubt. I see you have a lot of ties to home. You have a song about leaving.
Yeah, I even got my Saints on back there. I see Saints Seahawks back there. I don't know a score on it.
How are they doing? Still 0-0. Can somebody get them a score? Can we get a score read? 7-0 who? Hey, this is going to be a good interview
that,
now.
Baby?
Thank you. You probably lied. They're down 7-0, but that's all right. So did you think this was all going to happen for you? Because you were like one of those artists that came like kind of out of nowhere, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Like had a number one song real fast and then another huge song right after that. Now you got Slow Dance in a Parking Lot. Did you foresee this happening?
I really didn't. I moved to Nashville to write songs. I had never played a show. I never played with a full band. I can say this now because I had only played one full band show whenever I signed my record deal. So, like, I mean, there's still some things that I'm learning as an artist. But no, to think of where I'm at now, never in a million years I would have thought that would have happened.
So has your focus shifted now? Like, do you still want to be a writer or do you want to be an artist performer?
Well, I'm still like, I mean, you know, I still love to write songs and I wrote all my songs on my first album. It looks like I'm going to be a writer on all the songs on my second album too. So, I mean, that's something that I'm always going to do. I think now it's just kind of like, you know, becoming a better performer, you know, learning to just engage with the crowds, which we've been on some amazing tours, so we've been able to learn from a lot of really good entertainers, and I think just kind of trying to sharpen that side of my artistry.
From what I understand, and I haven't got to see you live, I can't wait to see you today, but I was talking to somebody who's like a major fan of yours,
and
they said you put on one of the best shows. They think you have
great.
So much energy, and it's great.
I mean, we put a lot of work into it, you know, and it's something that my band does a really, really good job of always trying to constantly get better at. So I'm glad that's the word.
How far are you with that next album then that you're just saying? Like, when is that coming?
So we've got 6 songs recorded right now. I think we're going to release a song really, really soon. And I'm hoping to get it out, you know, possibly this year, possibly early next year.
So you think you're going to release a radio single soon from the new stuff?
No, I mean
after Slow Dance
in
the Parking Lot,
obviously. Yeah, but I'm pretty sure that the next single after Slow Dance is going to be off the new project.
Sweet, that's
so
cool.
Yeah.
You have a baby on the way, right? You and your wife,
man.
Kristen?
November 19th.
November 19th. Are you nervous? And how's this going to fit
into
your crazy
hell,
life?
Man.
What's that?
I'm nervous as hell. No, I mean, I'm excited. I'm more anxious. You know, obviously it's gonna take me off the road for a little bit, but... you know, I mean, we've been hitting it pretty hard, man. I think we're coming up on 120 shows for the last 3 years, 120 plus for the last 3 years. So I think it's about time that we kind of regroup and just, you know, focus on some other things. Me and Dad, you know, I got a new dad. My bass player just had a baby. I think it's time for us to take a little break. But it's also good just, I think, as being creative to come up with song ideas. And to miss playing live, you know. So I'm looking forward to all aspects of it.
That's true. So you've been playing that much, taking yourself away for a little while will give you that little spark.
No, absolutely. I mean, we're looking forward to it.
All right, one more question, and it has to do with it's a grooming question. How did you get the perfect beard? What'd
beard,
you do? That had to
man,
take some work.
Beard oil, jeans. You know, I got to give it to my mom and my dad, man. My dad could always grow a really good beard, so I knew I had potential. See, like, I can grow a good one. Jacob can't grow a beard like I can.
I wouldn't think he could grow a beard.
Yeah.
I would think he gets, like, that caterpillar mustache.
Yeah, he does. He does. And, man, it's...
And you got the mountain man brawny beard.
Man, a lot of beard oil. Beard shampoo is huge. And jeans. That's
it. You take
it.
Care of it, man. Like a pelt.
Man.
That's
Dude, you
good.
Got to.
All right, look at the camera. Say something to Boston right now. We'll wrap this
Boston,
thing up.
Boston, love you guys. If you're not playing the Saints, go Pats.
All right, give it up. Jordan Davis!